Hi everyone, my name is Nas. I have an Etsy shop with the name Sewing Panda Patterns, where I sell digital sewing patterns. I'll leave the link of this pattern in the description box. You can purchase it from there. In this video, I'm going to show you sewing instructions. For this, we need elastic, zipper footer, zip, and pattern pieces. So let's start with joining side panels to the center front panel, pin in and stitch it, then press the seams. Repeat the same thing with the lining. Here I'm using same fabric as lining, but it's up to you. You can use plain lining fabric. Next, I'm joining the back side panels to the back center panel. Here I'm going to attach the zipper at the back, so that's why it's open. Repeat the same thing with the lining. Next, attach the front and back at the shoulders. Stitch it, then press it. Repeat the same thing with the lining. Next, coming to the ties, I have already made one as you can see. For this, fold the fabric half in lengthwise and stitch it with a 1 cm seam allowance from the raw edges and make the shape like this. Trim the excess fabric, then turn it right side with the loop turner, then press it. Next, I'm going to attach both the main and lining fabric by sewing the neck. Pin in and stitch the neck all over by sandwiching the ties between main and lining fabric at the back. Now trim the notches at corner. Make sure not to trim beyond the thread. Then turn it right side and press it. Next, I'm going to give understitch on the lining, as you can see. Now I'm going to join both the lining and main fabric all over with a large stitch. Next, I'm going to stitch the sides with the right sides together, so pin in, then stitch it. As you can see, I have stitched the sides and overlocked it. If you don't have serger, you can finish it with a zigzag stitch, or you can even use pinking scissors. Coming to the sleeve, as you can see, there are notches which indicates front, back and center. So start sewing two rows with a large stitch length between two notches for making gathers. And also fold the sleeve, then stitch the sides and overlock it. Next, I'm going to make a channel to insert the elastic at sleeve hem by leaving little space to insert the elastic. Now pull the thread and make gathers at center, as you can see. Then attach the sleeve to the bodice with the right sides together by matching notches. Stitch it, then overlock it. The bodice is completed, so coming to the skirt, it is a large half circle. So first I'm going to make gathers at skirt waist by stitching two rows with a larger stitch length. Now fold the fabric half twice, leaving seam allowance, then mark notches. Do the same thing with bodies. This will help in distributing the gathers evenly all over. Now pull the thread and make gathers to match the bodice waist, then attach it to the bodice, pin in, then stitch it and overlock it. As you can see, I have overlocked the hem and the center back raw edges so that I can attach the zipper. Next, I'm going to attach the zipper by using zipper footer. Then fold the zipper inside and finish it with a few hand stitches. Next, close the center back completely up to the zipper. Now you need a lot of fabric for making gathers at bottom of the skirt, and also you can see so many joints here. So first I'm going to do the narrow hem on two sides. All measurements are in the pattern, so need not to worry. Next, on one side, I'm going to make gathers. So I'm going to stitch two rows with the largest stitch length. As I have shown you earlier, we need to fold the fabric twice, then make marks on both the rectangle piece and also circle like this to distribute the gathers evenly all over. The final step, attach the gathers to the skirt. Now pull the basting stitches or large stitches with the seam ripper. I hope you like the pattern and instructions. You can purchase it from my Etsy shop, link in the description box. And please provide your feedback. It really helps me to grow my shop. Thank you.